Welcome back all the participants for the second session of the day. So we have with us Mr. Ajay Godara. Mr. Ajay Kumar Godara is the founder and director of Innovation Lab. And Innovation Lab is basically NITR Chandigarh startup initiative. He is also innovator and mentor of change of Niti Aayog, Government of India. And he has expertise in the area of robotics, Internet of Things, and AI. And he has developed many innovative projects and products and having patent in renewable energy area. He has delivered more than 500 expert talks in national and international FDPs. And he has also conducted training for students, and he has trained more than 20,000 students in this area. So I hope you will get benefited from his vast experience, and you will get major information regarding this free or open sources he has with him. So I welcome you, Ajay ji, and the session is over to you now.
Thank you, madam. Thank you so much. Am I audible, madam?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, thank you, madam. So very good morning to all the participants over here. And in today's session, we are going to discuss about some open source tool that we can use it for remote learning applications. So my focus over here to discuss very important tool for learning basic of electronics, basic of IoT, microcontrollers, sensors. So those things are required hardware whenever we have to build it. So now we are going to discuss that how you can build some interesting projects without having any kind of hardware using open source tool. So the tool we are going to use it over here, that is Tinkercad. So I'm directly going to start with the Tinkercad tool, and I will show that how you can build and how you can make it learnable for the student in an easy way in a remote learning mode, because now everyone is affected with the COVID-19 impact. So how you can use it for remote learning applications. So we are going to use over here, that is a remote XY tool. The Tinkercad we are going to use first. Tinkercad. So what is Tinkercad? Tinkercad is an online tool. So I'm going to open it in the Google. So what we have to do, you have to search on the Google with the name of Tinkercad. So as we are going to search it over there, you will be able to see the tinkercad.co. So you have to open it. And this one is a free and open source. So, and also reliable software, because this one is being built by Autodesk company. So that is a renowned company in a designing software. So over here, we are going to use that remote XY tool, Tinkercad tool for learning in a remote area using open source. Now over here, you can see that how you can build your account in this remote XY tool, and what are the features that you can use it for a remote learning application. So first of all, I'm going to do sign out over here so that you can see that how you can do login over here. So as you are going to do, open that Tinkercad tool directly from that Google, it will look like this. So what we have to do over there, you have to do sign in. Or you can join now. If you are doing it first time, you have to do join now option. And then you will find educator. You start here, student join a class, and you can create a personal account. So we are going to create a personal account right now. So over there you have to click it, and you have to sign in with the email, or you can sign in with Google also. So when we have to do sign in with the email, you have to click over there. And then after that, you have to select your country. So I'm searching India, select India. And after that, the date of birth, that should be more than 18. So if you are going to enter any rough date of birth, so you can face difficulty while doing login. So that should be more than 18. So any date you can enter it, but that should be more than 18. So click next. So now, after that, What you can do, you can enter your email address. So I'm just entering my email address. So if you are doing first time, then you can select your password also. So it is saying that this email address is already registered because I have already did my registration with my mail ID. So you can enter it and it will let you know that with the tick mark that yes, your email address is available, you can do sign. And over there you have to type password, select it, agree it, and create account. You can do it easily. So now over here I'm going to sign in with my previous account that I have created it. And I'm going to enter my mail ID. So that you can do it easily if you have created your account over there. I'm going to sign in over there. Next, it will ask about the password. And the password you can type your own password. So I'm going to try it if it is working. Now it is working. So over there you will find the previous project if I have created any project over there. So that you will find it over there. So I will share with you a few previous projects that I have designed over there. So very important point is there that when we are using these different option over there. So as after doing sign in that remote in that Tinkercad, over there you will find first one is 3D design. So like if you are mechanical teacher, civil teacher, so you can teach your kids the designing in a very easy way using this open source tool. So over there, first of all, you have to create a new design. So I'm just going to show that how you can use this Tinkercad for designing any 2D or 3D object. And after that, you can do 3D printing also. That is also very easy. So now I'm going to use it. So first of all, what we have to do over here, we will find that workspace, and these are pre-built blocks. I mean, we have to directly use these blocks, and we can use those blocks for directly building any kind of 3D model. So let me take this cube or this box, just drag it and drop it, very easy to use. Just drag it, all the shapes you will find it over here, and then you can increase their size or whatever dimension you want to change it, that you can do it. So like if any electronic student also want to work in that domain, or electrical student, they can also learn that 3D designing easily. And like this one, and after that these are views, like front views, top views and side views. This one is a home view, and you can do fit to screen. And over there, if you are going to make some hollow part or you want to create some hole, so you can take that cylinder and you can put it over there. And after that, you can see in a front view their depth of that cylinder, or you can increase their height also. And now you can move it bottom or slightly. And again, you can go to home and the top view. From the top, you can see their position. Like if you want to align that cylinder with the center of this cube, so this rectangular type slab. So I'm going to select both the objects, and there is one tool of alignment over there, align. So now there is option, you can align it from over here in this side, in center of this line and center of this line. Now this cube, this slab and one cylinder, both are aligned in the center point. Go to home, you can see it. The front view, you will be able to see it. Now, over here, after seeing it, what we can do, we have to club it. How we can make hollow over here? Select both the objects like this, and then there is option of grouping. So as we are going to do group, so the hollow part will created over here automatically like this, that you can see. This one hollow part is being created in this slab. Now what I want to do, I want to make 3D printing of this part. So that also we can do it easily.
So how we can do 3D printing over there, let's see how we can make it. So I'm going to export it. So there is option of export or send to. So when we are clicking on the send to, you can send it another software or 3D printing or 3D designing software, or you can take screenshot of this also and you can export it also. Like when we are exporting it, you can do directly 3D printing also. If you are having these 3D printer, those are open source 3D printer, if those are available, so you can directly do 3D printing, or you can download it also. So when we are downloading any 2D or 3D design, so we have to do 3D printing. So we have to export that file in a .stl format. STL is a stereolithographic format that we are using while making 3D printing. So directly you can export it, and after that you can open that file in a 3D printer and you can use it. So that can be done easily over there. So this one is designing, you can do it easily and you can share it, and you can export it also. And very important point, when you are designing it, our student designing their any kind of design, so they can share with you also, like they can share with the teacher, so you can invite them, or there is one link is being generated, generate new link. And if you're going to share this link, so those participants are able to access this link, they can open that same circuit, same design, and they will able to do modification, whatever they want to do it. So that also can be done. So that is sharing their work easily. So over there you will find many shapes, different kind of shapes over there you will find. So these are work plane, play ruler, all the tools you will find it for the design, and easily you will able to do design. So now I'm coming back to another advantage of this tool. So over there you can save your design also. So how you can save your design? Click over there and you can rename it. So you can name it basic design. So that design will be get saved on the cloud. Coming back over there. So if we are going back in this home screen on the Tinkercad, you will be able to see your design. So over there you will find your latest design. This one is a basic design created 6 minutes ago that you can see it. Now after that, this one is your design. If you want to open it, that also you can do it. If you want to download it, that also you can directly do it. So that can be done easily over there. And if you want to see view in a 3D, that also you can see it over here directly, the 3D view, this one. So like whatever mode you want to see it, that you can rotate it and you can check it out. So now after that, this one is project is already saved. So whatever project you are going to build it, all the project is being get saved over there. And if you are going to import any project, that also you can import it. Like if you are going to design any mask or something like that, so that project you can import it and you can use it over here. So a few basic lesson also you will find it over here, like Tinkercad lesson. And as you are going to click on the lesson, you will find more detailed tutorials over there about lesson. All lesson plan you can see it over there. Art, computer science, design, engineering, and math and all that. So like if you are going to talk about engineering, so few engineering design, different, you will find it over there and you can make it. And if you talk about design, then also you will find few design over there, and at the bottom you will find more details. So now coming back to the Tinkercad, this one is about design part. Like participants belongs to civil and mechanical engineering, they can work it easily over there and they can start building a design in an easy way from the beginning, from the scratch. Because when we talk about diploma students, they coming in a first year after 10th class, it's very tough for them to understand any kind of designing from and making any kind of design, like different geometry we have to make it. But over there they can start building and start learning in a remote area without having any kind of software. Because when we have to do any kind of designing work over there, we have to install some software or we have to take some license, like we are using AutoCAD and SolidWorks. These are some different designing software we are using it. But over here, no need any kind of license. you can use it open source and you can make your design easily. Now after that, you can go to the circuit part, and in the circuit you can make any kind of circuit over there in this tool. So this one is the second tool for the electronics, electrical and computer science students. They can work over here in this circuit and they can create their design easily. So what they can do, you have to click on the circuit and you will find all the previous circuit that you have designed it. If you have designed it, but if you are using it first time, then you will not find any circuit over there. So go to the circuit and click on create new design. So as you are going to click on create new design, over there you will find this one workspace. Okay, so now I'm just asking from the participant that how many participants are familiar with the Tinkercad? Respond in the chat box, yes and no. How many participants are familiar with the Tinkercad? Respond in the chat box, yes and no. So respond in the chat box, yes and no. If you are familiar with the Tinkercad, you have to respond yes. Otherwise, you have to respond no. Okay. So now I'm coming back to Tinkercad. So over here, this one is a workspace. In this workspace, what you can do, you can make your circuit easily. You can test your electrical, electronic skill over there easily and your programming skill also. So how you can make learning easy and learning with the fun? Let's see it over here. So these are components. You will find all the basic components over here. If you are from the mechanical background and if you are from the civil background, then also you can build your circuit easily over here without having any kind of hardware component. So let's see how you can make it. So over here in the workspace, I'm just discussing about all the menus and all the tools over here in this Tinkercad. Let's see how you can use it. First of all, we are going to take one LED. So this one is the LED. I'm going to take it. And after that, if you want to increase or decrease that LED size, so how you can do it? You can use your mouse and the mouse scroller, you can use it for increasing or decreasing their size. And second thing is that there is option of fit to screen. So if you're going to do it, zoom to fit, you can do it easily over there. And if you want to increase or decrease size, that also you can decrease. Now I want to use this LED over here and I'm going to connect this LED with the battery. So this one is the battery, you can take it, drag it and drop it. So that is all the component you will find it over here in the Tinkercad that is similar to that is available in the market. So that the color and their shape you will find the same. So that you will not get confused that this component you have to take it. So now what I'm going to do it over here, I'm going to connect it. This one is anode. Anode, I'm going to connect it with negative. And the third, I'm going to connect it positive. So now I'm going to check it out that my LED is working or not. So you can start simulation with this. You can start simulation using this. So I'm going to start. These are very simple circuit. Like I'm just connecting LED directly with the battery, nothing else. So now after that, I'm going to start simulation. So let it see. So I'm going to start simulation. This one is my circuit. So what I'm going to do it over here, I'm going to start simulation. So how we can start simulation? This one is option, start simulation, but my LED is not working. So why my LED is not working? You have to respond in the chat box. You have to respond in the chat box. So why my LED is not working? What is the reason behind that my LED is not working? If you are familiar with the basic LED circuit and with the battery, so you can respond in the chat box that why my LED is not working. Yes and no. So why my LED is not working? What is the reason behind that? So you can respond over here in the chat box. You have to be active over here in this session for getting maximum benefit out of it. So I'm not getting any response. Yes, getting. It's 9-volt battery. So what we have to do, if the battery is 9-volt over there, so what we have to do, there is no ground. Okay. So ground we have connected over there with this LED. This one is a negative. You can make it ground, black color, and this one is positive. You can make it red. Then still my LED is not working. So what can be more possible reason over there? So that you can see it. So now what is the reason behind that? The major switching is not there, switch is not required, resistance, yes, resistance can be one reason. We have to know the break in voltage. Okay, that is 2 volt is required, that is break in voltage. Okay, yes. So now there is very common fault, and that is very much important. What is that common fault over here? That is connection of this LED. So this one is a cathode, cathode is negative and this one is a positive. So we made a reverse connection over here. That's why LED is not working. So I'm going to change these connections. Yes, that's great because all the participants are so much active. So this one is cathode. Cathode we have to connect with the ground and that should be black. And this one we have to connect with the positive, that you can make it red. Color coding also you can do it over here. So how you can connect wire? Again, I'm repeating, how you can connect that wire. So if you have to connect wire, so click on this terminal and your wire will be start ready. Sometime what is happening, you are clicking multiple times, so your wire become too long. So if you want to end this wire, how you can end it? For ending this wire, you can delete this option directly. So as we are going to delete it, wire get deleted. And again, if you want to end this wire, you have to connect this wire with the second end, like this. Wire will get end. And you can do color also, like red. Now I'm going to check it out, why, how my LED is working. Yes, my LED is working, but my LED get damaged. Now your theory is coming over there, that resistance we have not used over there, that is also correct. And second one is that you should know that break in voltage, that is also you should know. So now what I'm going to do, my LED get damaged over here. So what is the reason behind it for damaging my LED? Take your mouse cursor on this LED and you can see the current through the LED is 915 milliampere. But while the absolute maximum is required for a LED, that is 20 milliampere, that you can see. So how we can reduce current flow in this circuit? So what we have to do, we have to use resistance. Okay, so we are going to use resistance over here. So now you have to tell over here that how much value of that resistance we have to use it. So you have to tell me in the chat box that how much value of resistance is required to glow this LED and few parameter that I'm going to give you. So voltage requirement for this LED is 2 volt. Or as I have shown over here, the current requirement of this LED is 20 milliampere. So how much value of resistance we have to use it? So I'm expecting a lot of answer from you. So you can give any guess also over there that how much resistance value we have to insert it over here. So I'm just directly connecting one resistance and meanwhile you can calculate that value and you can tell me the same value I'm going to use over here. So this one I'm going to connect it. So you can make it black. So I have connected one resistance, but you have not responded in the chat box that how much value of that resistance we have to take it. So I'm just taking it in ohm, 1 ohm. So let it see it is working or not. LED still get damaged. So I'm going to increase that value. So let me make it 100 ohm. Yes. Now LED is working, but it is showing some warning. So what warning it is showing? So go to your, take your mouse cursor over there and you can see that current through the LED is 65 milliampere while recommended maximum is 20 milliampere. So what we have to do, if we are going to use in this configuration, so yes, some participant responded 450 ohm. So 450 ohm is not a correct answer. So it will work on that 450 ohm, but you know, that is the LED will glow in under voltage, under current. So I'm going to make it 350. So 350 is the correct answer for this. You can calculate using Ohm's law. So that calculation you can do it, that I'm not going to discuss right now because my motto over here to discuss this tool so that you can use it for remote learning and you can use it as open source. So what I did, I just set up it 350. In a 450 also it will work. So Sarvan Kumar at 450, this one will work, but the brightness will be get reduced little bit. So you can use 450 also, but as per calculation, exact value is 350 ohm. Now it is working fine. So everything you can check it on the simulation, no need any kind of hardware, and after that you can deploy it on the hardware. Now I'm just going to use some, if you want to save this project, how you can save it, that is very interesting over here. So I'm going to save my project. So how you can save it? For saving your project, you can go over here and you can save it with the name of LED with battery. I just connected it, and after that, LED with battery. Yes, now you can go back to this Tinkercad, and over there, you will able to find your latest circuit. This one is LED with the battery. You can open it again, and you can share with another one also. Like if you want to share this circuit with the student, that also you can share it. So I'm going to open it again, click over there and tinker. I'm going to tinker this. Now, how you can share this circuit with your student? So there is option over here, share. So you can click on the share and you can take screenshot also. Like sometimes student has to build a report. So what they can do, they can directly go to share, and whatever circuit they made it over here, they can download it and they can see over here like this. So the circuit can be visible in a screenshot. The picture they can use in their file. So now if they want to share with another participant, so how they can share it? So I think the screen is visible. Share, go to share, and there is option over there, invite people. Like earlier we did with the design. So over there you can click invite people and you can copy that link. That link you can share with your student. So student can access that circuit directly. So that is one mode. And if you want to monitor your student work, that what they did it, that is correct or not. And if you want to monitor it in real time, so what you can do, you can create a classroom also over here. So I'm just sharing with you that classroom also after discussing this tool with more applications. Yes, let's do some interesting application over there and how you can do coding also over here. So first of all, I'm going to discuss like motor. Let's take this motor, and I want to control that motor speed using some sensor. So this one is a sensor. So you can simulate that sensor also, and I'm going to use one battery also over here. I take this battery, and if you want to rotate that battery, how you can rotate it? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to rotate this battery. So for rotating this battery, there is option over here, first one, this one, rotate. Select that battery and rotate it. So you can rotate it using this tool. And now I'm going to connect this battery. This one is positive. So now this one is a LDR. So LDR is also called photo resistor. When we are searching over here, you will find photo resistor. So you can see it over there. Now after that, you can start simulation. So simulation can be get started. So as we are starting simulation, let's see how it is working. And you can do color coding of the wire easily over there. So start simulation. So how this photo resistance is working, photo resistance, or we can call it LDR sensor, light dependent resistor. So how we can use it? So let me show you separately that how this sensor is working. Take the sensor, take multimeter, and you can connect this with this. So you can use multimeter little bit aside, connect negative part with this wire, and this one I'm going to connect with positive. And I'm going to check this multimeter, check this LDR sensor. So how resistance is varying and how you can read that resistance in a multimeter. Multimeter is also available over there. Sometime in our laboratories, some are like a basic tool like oscilloscope and multimeters are not available. So they can you can use over here in this remote learning mode, and you can use it on this Tinkercad tool without purchasing it. So I want to check my resistance value of this LDR. Now this sensor is at full darkness mode. So what we have to do, we have to click on the resistance, or as we are changing light intensity, there is no change on the multimeter. So click over there and click on R. resistance. And on the resistance, as you are going to move it, this one is light intensity. I'm increasing it in a simulation mode in this Tinker CAD. And over there, you can see that as I'm decreasing light intensity at full darkness, the resistance value will be 180 kilo ohm. And as I'm increasing over here, that value of resistance or light intensity, my resistance is decreasing. And the value is 506 ohm. Now, you can, same LDR sensor I have used over here. So this sensor is working as a resistive type, meaning as I'm increasing light intensity, resistance will increase, sorry, decrease. And when we are increasing darkness, resistance will increase over here like this. So I'm going to check it over here. Click on this and you can see the motor RPM. RPM is also visible because when we have to measure RPM of a motor in the real time, we have to use a tachometer, that device for measuring RPM. But sometimes that device we are not having. So we can use it over here in the Tinkercad, and as we are clicking on the sensor, so we are reducing that resistance by increasing light intensity. So as I'm increasing light intensity, you can see that RPM is increasing. You can see over here, RPM is increasing. Why RPM is increasing? Because more the light intensity on the sensor, or less resistance will be over there. And if less resistance is over there in the circuit, more current will be flow in the circuit. Now you can see RPM is 1973 RPM. You can reduce it. Yes. So this one is the beauty of this tool. You can use it. So now I'm going to delete this one part. And if you want to save this project, that also you can save it. So LDR motor speed control, you can type your name, motor speed control, and you can save it. Click over here, and after that your project will be get saved. So after that you are going in a home screen, and in a home screen over there you will find it. So check over here. So this one is your latest project, that is motor speed control. So now I'm just going to talk about some more tools over here. The first one is the coding part, how you can make automatic projects over there. So let me go over there. So over here you can see there is one microcontroller, two microcontrollers over there. So what you can do with these microcontrollers, so what we can do over there, so you can take that microcontroller like this. This one is the Arduino Uno board. So I'm not discussing that Arduino Uno board. If you are familiar with it, that's great. So how many participants are familiar with this Arduino Uno microcontroller development board? So respond in the chat box, yes and no. How many of participants are familiar with this Arduino Uno board? Respond in the chat box, yes and no. Yes and no. So how many participants are familiar with this Arduino Uno board? That is microcontroller development board, and that is being used now in this day. In a school also. So if you are not familiar with it, so kindly start getting familiar about this tool. That is very wonderful microcontroller development board, so that you can use it for many application of IoT, many application, many projects. You can build it using it. Yes. Three participants responded over here, and they are saying it, yes, that's great. If you are not familiar about it, then you can get familiar also about it, that how you can use it, how you can program it. So when we talk about multidisciplinary approach, and when we talk about any mechanical student, if they have to program it, when we talk about any civil engineering student, or sometime when we talk about electrical and electronic student, they used to face difficulty while writing code in this microcontroller. Because when we have to write code in this microcontroller board, we have to write in an embedded C. So if they are not familiar with the C, they face difficulty. But how we can learn that coding in a very easy way? That I'm going to tell you over here in remote learning mode also. So if you want to write code, so you can connect one LED. I'm going to connect one LED directly on pin number 13, one terminal with the ground, second terminal with the 13 number pin, and start simulation. So my LED will start working over here, but I have not written any single line of code. Without writing code, my LED is working. So over here you can see my LED is working. So why my LED is working over here without writing any code? So you can see it. So you can go to the code. So this one is a graphical coding. You can use it if you are not familiar with the embedded C. What you can do, you can use graphical coding over there in a very easy way. So over here, we are going to use same graphical coding over there. So let's see how you can use that graphical coding. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to use that same graphical coding over here. So how you can write that code, I'm going to delete. There is one dustbin at the bottom. Again, if you want to make code, you have to use only four menus over here. One is output, one is control, one is math, one is input. I will discuss about basic code right now, and I will share with you more interesting project that how you can build that kind of project, and I will share with you more resources also. So no need to worry about it. Be with me and don't leave this class. You are going to leave it, you are going to lose many things over here. So go to the output. In output, you will find set build in LED, or you can take the second one. Over here, you can select pin number. This one is the pin number 13. So on the 13 number pin, we want to give output. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use that 13 number pin. So go over there, select the pin number 13. And this one is high. Then again, go to the control. In a control, you will find all the condition, like if condition, else condition, all the condition you will find in a control. So take weight from over there, weight. Drag it and drop it easily. And you will be able to do it easily. So, what we can do over there, we can go to again control and go to the output, and over there in the output we are going to again we can take the second block, select that pin number 30, and then again go to control and take that pin. So this one will repeat for infinite times. LED will be high, and again high we can make it low. So one interval, 1 second is the interval. You can start simulation. LED will start working on 30 number pin. So what we have to do over there, we have to check over here that LED. If we want to increase or decrease the timing, you can increase it also. LED blinking time, I want to increase it. So I have to reduce that delay. So I'm going to start simulation. Then now you will be able to see LED will blink faster. I think you are able to see it. So after that, what we have to do,
sir, what is the message over the LED?
What, sir? Kindly repeat your question.
I think there is a information here, notification over LED. What is that?
Yes, that is indicating that current is flowing that is higher than required, because we are supplying 5 volt from over here, but requirement voltage of this LED is 2 volt. So what we have to do, we have to use the resistance over here. But right now I have not used it for saving time, so we can use the resistance, and that warning will be go away.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
So this one again, I'm connecting it with the resistance, and resistance value will be right now for 5 volt. That will be in ohm, and that will be 150 ohm. So I'm going to use that value. You can do that calculation using Ohm's law, and you can start simulating. You can see LED is working fine. So, and you can change that color also, that LED color. If you want to get yellow, green, blue, so that color also you can change. Now I want to change the pin number. Like if you want to program it for any another pin, select it, 10 number, and over here also 10. Now start simulation. LED will not work on the 30 number pin. Now replace this pin number with 10 number pin. So I'm going to stop it and going to use it on 10 number pin. Then start simulation. So simulation can be get started over there like this. This one you can see. So your simulation get started, and on 10 number pin LED is blinking with the same interval. So if you want to delete that code, you can delete it. And very important point, when we have to upload this code in the hardware, we have to upload in an embedded C. So how you can use this code? So stop simulation, and after that go to block. Stop simulation, go to block. Click over there and you will find block plus text. So whatever code you have used in a block, your embedded C code will generate it automatically. This code you can copy and you can upload it in the Arduino software. So Arduino software, you have to use it for uploading it in a hardware, and you can upload it easily so that you can do it. So how this code is being generated, you can see it. I'm deleting it. There is no code. And go to the output, take this block, select pin number 10, then go to control, take delay. Then after that, you can use one more shortcut command also. Right click over here in this block and you will find duplicate. So you will be able to duplicate it also for doing it faster. So LED high for 1 second, low for 1 second, and your code generated automatically in embedded C. So that's the beauty of this tool, that you can use it and you can make your project easily over there. So now after that, this one you can use it in a very simple way. You can write code and you can download that code also over here. This one is the option. You can download it. Code will get downloaded, and you can save it also. Let me copy it from over here, and you can paste it in the Arduino software. That can be done easily. So now coming back to this, what more you can build it over here in the Tinkercad. So how you can do some more programming, and some queries was there that how we can share it. So go to share, and there is option of invite people. Click on this and your link will generate it. Copy this link, and you can share that link with anyone, so they will be able to access that link. So this one you can do it easily, and over there is some comment if you want to put it. So over there, like if you want to write that resistance value, 150 ohm, so that also you can write it. Or that also you can define it easily over there. So this one we have indicated it. And this one is a USB, you can connect it. Now, if you want to connect any sensor, to many sensor, you will find it over there. And let's go over there and let's discuss all. So over there, you will find all the detailed component now. If you want to use the flex sensor, and then force sensor, photodiode, ultrasonic sensor, and then ultrasonic distance sensor, PIR sensor. So motors, batteries, yes, very interesting activity. You can do it over here. So let me share with you that one. If you want to make a battery at your home, that also you can make it, like lemon battery if you want to make it using this tool. So how you can use it. You can see it. Okay. So you can take this battery, lemon battery, and you can take this. So over here you can see it. So two batteries, I just made it, and you can make it at your home using that nail, and you can take any copper coin and you can insert it in your lemon and potato, and you can make that battery. And you can check their voltage also using multimeter. So I'm just checking their battery voltage using multimeter. So I'm going to connect this multimeter with this negative and positive with positive. And again, one more multimeter, I'm going to take it and going to connect it. So are you enjoying it? Yes and no, you can respond in the chat box. So if you are enjoying this session, otherwise I will discuss only basic part. If you are enjoying this, you can respond in the chat box, yes, otherwise you can type no. So I'm going to start simulation and going to check it out. Over there, you can see the voltage we are generating using lemon battery, that is 520 millivolt. And over here in this battery, in the potato battery, we are generating more than this lemon battery voltage, that is 670 millivolt. Now you can connect multiple potatoes and you can make series connection and you can generate voltage over there easily. So that can be generated over there. So now over here, what we have to do it, we have to take multiple battery and we can connect it. So if you are enjoying this session, you can respond in the chat box, yes. And otherwise you can respond no. Okay, some participant is expecting that share over here few more 3D design model. Okay, that also I will share, no need to worry. Okay. So this one, whatever you are going to make it, that also you can save it via this. So over here by default name you will find it. So everyone has their different name over there. Click over there and you can save it. The name, and after that click on this workspace, your name will be get saved automatically. You can see it. Then after that go back in this Tinkercad and you will find that project in your history over there, lemon battery. So that you will find it. So all the project you can see it over there. So some participant is asking that how we can use that 3D design in a more way. So go to 3D design and create a new design. So I'm just sharing with you a few interesting design. If you are going to build it, like key chain ring, if you are going to make it, or if you are going to make key chain, how you can make it. So take this block, put it over there, and after that I'm going to change their dimension. You can zoom it also. I'm going to increase their length, and after that I want to decrease that height. So after that, if I have to connect any ring over there, how I can connect it? So over there you will find some ring. This one you can take it and you want to insert it. So if you want to move it in this side, you can move it. If you want to move this, that you can move it. You have to insert it over here. So how you can insert it properly? So you can go to home, pick to screen. Yes, now it will be seen properly. So now what we have to do, we want to set it properly so that it can get inserted. So go in a front view and you can see this one is not properly getting inserted. So what we have to do, we can increase their height. So I'm going to increase a little bit their height. Or if you want to align it, that also you can do it. So I want to align it on the center. So I'm going to select both the object and you can use this alignment. So we are going to align it. Let me go fit to screen. Yes, this one is alignment in the center. So this one is alignment over here in the middle. Now I did alignment, go to the front view, you can see it. Now it is properly visible and you can see this one is properly aligned. So now what we have to do it over here. So we have to club both the parts. So this one part we have to club it so that we can do it. So select both the parts and after that you can go to this grouping. So as we are going to group it, so this one will become only one part like this. But if you want to maintain both the color different, so you can click on this solid and over there you can use multicolor. So as we are going to click it, so this one will be in multicolor and this become one part. Now you want to engrave some name over there. So how you can engrave any name? So I'm going to engrave it. So you can take some text, take it, and go to home, zoom it. So this one is a text. You can see in the front view how much height is required. So height is a little bit high. So what you can do, you can move your tool and this text up and down. Using this. So I'm going to engrave my name through hole, or you can decrease their height also using this. So I want to engrave my name like this. So go to again home view. So I want to insert this text box over here. So I want to increase their decrease their size, decrease it, and bring it over here like this. And if you want some different color, so this one you can select any other color. But we want to engrave it. So one part is engraving, in making these words, removing that material, and second part is that how we can add some material over here. So first we are going to add material in this phase, and this text material we want to edit, but we want to rename it. So over there in this text, you can rename it like, and you want to open source tool. So you can make post community or something like that. So you can rename over there. So whatever name you want to insert over there, that you can insert it. So that is being a display. So now what you want to do, you want to engrave this name over here and you want to align it. So what you can do, go to home, go to screen, and I'm going to select both the part and I'm going to click on alignment. So now it is showing that alignment, how you want to align it. So I want to align it in the center like this, and in the center also over here. So it's coming on complete center, so we have to make it only complete center in this, not in center. So let me do undo it. So how you can undo it? You can undo it like this. So let me select only these two parts, but it is already clubbed, that's why it's selecting complete part. So go to top view and see it, it is center. So if you want to align it, you can remove that part or ungroup this part, then also you can center it. So now I want to engrave material over there. So in this part, select it, this one is a solid. If you are going to make it solid, so this part will get added, this material will be get added. So see in the top view, front view, and how much height you are going to maintain it. So now what we have to do is select both the parts, all the parts, and you can group it. So as we are going to group it, this material is being got added over there, and you can use it multicolor. So now this part is ready to use. You can see that keyring is ready now. Keyring with this, you can see it, the engraving part, you can use it. But if you want to, not engraving, this one is the adding part, adding material. If you want to engrave it, for that what you can do, undo it and now select this one part and you can make it hollow, so this will get engraved in this part. So now I'm going to make it group. So select both of them and group it. So now you can, you will able to see this part will get engraved over here. Now you can see second part is get engraved over there. You can see it if you are able to see it, that you can do it easily. So similar way you can make many interesting design over there. I just share with you one example, and you can do 3D printing also with this key, so that you can do it like any size modification you want to do it, many more things you can do it, any hollow part you want to make it, that also you can make it. So now I'm going over here in this home, and over there coming back to the Tinkercad, and I'm just going to talk about few more circuits over there. So let's see over here, go back to Tinkercad for me, and now I'm just sharing with you few more projects over here in the circuit part. If you talk about circuit part, how you can build some projects over there. So these are basic projects I have discussed. So let me sign in with another account. So over there, there is many projects, a few of them are helpful for you, that I'm sharing with you. So join now, sign in with a personal account. Create a personal account, sign in with the Google. So it will ask about account. So that account I'm going to select it. So as it is sign in over there, after doing sign in, I'm going to see a few more projects over there. And also I will share with you that how you can create your class. So whatever your student is making, anything over there in a class, you will be able to see it over there. So over there, you can go, I'm just going to log in another account. That account was created as an educator. In this educator account, what we can do, go to the circuit. So over there you will find classes. So as I'm going to click on the class, so in a class you can create a new class. So how you can create your new class? if you want to do remote teaching, so click on create new class, and you can find write the name of that class and age group or college, then select the engineering department, then create a class. So this one class is already available. Let me make it create class. As we are going to create a class, so your new class will be created. So where is my new class? So that will be, I think, is the bottom. So unassigned student. So this one is saying that the student is not assigned for that class. Unassigned student. Okay, this one is another class. Okay. So if you want to add any student over there in a class, so how you can add it? Like, just take an example. These are class I have created. So class is robotics class. Yes, this one class I recently created, but there is no student. So what you can do, you can add a student with the class code. So click add student, and you can type their name, and their nickname will be get generated automatically. And you can paste a list of the student, and you can add all the student over there directly. That also you can add it. So when any student has to join this class, they have to use that nickname that you have assigned it. Then only they will able to join that class in the Tinkercad without doing sign in over there in the Tinkercad directly, that they can use it. And this one is a class link. So that class link is being generated over there. So you can go back. So class link also gets generated. So how you can generate that class name? So robotics class, and let me open that class again. Class has 8. This one is a class code. So this link you can share with your student, and student will able to join with their nickname. So they can do it easily, and after that you will able to access their activity. So I'm going back to that class. So like 3D design class, and many more classes over there. So IoT class 1, I'm just going to open this class. So if that is a design class, so the design also you can see it. The circuit also you can see it. If any student has designed any circuit over there, so all the circuit of your students, you will able to see it over there. And any circuit, if you want to open it, that also you can open it. So if you want to watch specific student circuit, that also you can click on the student student, and over there you will find the name of the student. Click over there, and their account will be get open, the student account. Whatever student made any circuit over there, that you will able to access it, and you will able to modify it over there. So I'm just going in a circuit. So all the circuit of made by Saksi will be visible over here, and that you will able to see. So if you want to see their code, is there any mistake in the code, so you can copy this in Tinkercad, or you can simulate it directly. I'm going to simulate it. So we are going to simulate it. So as we are going to simulate it, so directly you can check their circuit and their working also. So let it get open. So it is opening over there, and after that you will be able to simulate it. There is some slow internet right now. That's creating some issue over there. So let it get open and wait for a second. So this one is about creating a class, and you can write some comment also over there. Like if anything you want to recommend to your student, so that you can recommend it, and one student is going to log in with that class, the student will be able to access that comment also. This one is circuit, and you can simulate it. So let it get open. Yes, this one is a circuit, and you can start simulation. If you want to simulate it and you want to check the code also, you can see. So what code made by the student, you can see it, and you can simulate it also. So let it start. Oh, some sound is coming. Yes. So two different sound is coming on the speaker. Are you able to listen that sound? Yes and no. You can respond in the chat box if you are able to hear that two different sounds. With the interval of some seconds. This one is code made over here by the student. If you're able to hear that sound, you can respond in the chat box. Yes, yes, that's great. So that interesting activity, you can do it over there. And you know, whatever student made it over here, I'm just able to observe it. And if there is any mistake in the code, we can write in the comment that you can improve this one and you can do it. So that you can do it easily. So now what I'm going to do, that is about the class. You can create your class and you can monitor all the student activity over there easily. And you can see all their circuit and all that. So that is wonderful tool. You can use it over there. And now I'm coming back to my class. So the class, you will find it. So let me go back to home screen. And I just share with you a few interesting project over here in a circuit. So let's see it, how you can make those circuits. Yes, this one is a social distancing gadget. So this one I'm going to open it. And like if anyone is going to break your social distancing, so it will be get alert you using one speaker. So let's see how it is working. So we are just going to maintain 2 gauge distance. So that is approximate 200 centimeters. So I'm going to use it. So you can start simulation and you can use it. So I'm going to start simulation and going to check it out how it is working. So now I click on the sensor. Now distance, it is showing that 239 of any person of any object. If any person coming closer to you and going to cross that 200 centimeter distance and again going back, so it will notify you using button. And that coding also you can make it in a graphical way easily, so that you can do it. So that is one application, and I'm sharing with you more application over here. Yes, over here that is a simple project. Now I'm just talking about this. This one is a multi-purpose project. So you can make automatic door opening. You can make automatic doorbell using this project, like contactless door opening that you can make it using this. For contactless doorbell, you can make it using this, because due to this COVID, you have to make everything contactless to avoid any kind of contact with the virus, or to avoid spread of, to stop that spread of that virus. So let's see how this one is working. So over there we are going to use PIR sensor, that is proximity infrared sensor that we are using it over here. So let's see it. So due to slow internet, it gets stopped. So let me open it again. Meanwhile, if any participant having any kind of doubt, they can type in the chat box and I will try to respond all your queries. Okay, so one more thing, like when we are using the Tinkercad and we are making any circuit over there, what you can do when we talk about the coding part. So coding is a little bit graphical coding we were doing, but you are not familiar about that coding. So what you can do over there, for using that graphical coding, there is one more tool to learn that graphical coding. That how you can learn that graphical coding, that I'm just going to discuss with you. Let's see how you can use that graphical coding. Let it get open. So meanwhile, I'm just going to share with you that graphical coding, and one more tool I'm going to use it, that is also open source tool. That is crash.mit.edu. So in this tool, how you can understand that graphical coding in an easy way, with a learning way, with a fun way. Let's see with a very small animation video over here. Let's see how it is working.
I think there is an issue of connection with this link.
Gutara sir, you are not audible. Sir, you can click on that hide button, na, or beside stop sharing.
So now voice is audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, audible.
Okay, thank you so much. So there was some connectivity issue. Okay. So we are just going to talk about this automatic doorbell project, so that you can use it in many applications. And this one is a scratch tool. We can use it for some basic application for understanding that graphical coding. Let's see how you can use it. So like move 10 step and then turn 50 degree. I'm going to simulate this cat, and then after that again move 10 step, and then I want to play some sound. Or my cat will start thinking after traveling a lot. So go to event or look. In the look, you will find say hello, say think like this. Then I want to go to control and I want to repeat it for 10 times. And I want to use 1 second delay. And I want to play some sound also. Sound. So my cat will play some sound, that is meow sound. So my cat will start playing meow meow sound. So let's see how it is working. So go to event, use this flag. When we click it, then click over there and start simulating. Are you able to hear that cat sound? Yes and no, respond in the chat box. This will repeat for 10 times. Now you can see over there. So this one is very simple code. You can use it over here to understand it. So that is only for using graphical coding, and you can record some customized voice also for this cat. That also you can do it in the sound, and over there you can record it. Like as I'm showing you that how you can record it. There is an option over here, play or copy paste and. A record option is also over there. You will find it from here. So over there is a record option like this. Hello, 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 hello. My cat is hungry. My cat is hungry. So you can record it like this. So hello, my cat is hungry. My cat is hungry. So you can stop it over here. So you can save that sound also, and you can play that sound also over there with cat. So hello, my cat is hungry. My cat is hungry. So you can make it. So hello, my And the sound also you can use it in your costume, in your code. So when we are using that meow sound, you can replace with recording one. So as you are going to play it, so hello, my cat is hungry. My cat is hungry. So that you can make it interesting activity over there in this tool. This one is a scratch software, and that you can find it in offline mode also, and you can use it in online mode also. Both mode is available over there for using this software. So now coming with few more interesting projects. So over here we are going to discuss some interesting projects. Let's see this one. If you want to get different tone at the output, so how you can get it? Let me show you over here this circuit. This one is very interesting project. You will enjoy it, and if you like it, you can respond in the chat box. Yes. over start simulation. So as we are going to increase light intensity in this sensor, we can increase sound. So as we are increasing or decreasing light intensity, we can vary that sound tone and we can get different kind of music. If you are able to hear it and if you are enjoying it, respond in the chat box, yes. So you can make it like this. So if you enjoy enjoying it, you can respond in the chat box, yes. Yes, so any kind of IoT class, any kind of basic electronics class, you can use it over there for circuit interfacing. So in all the electronics, electrical and computer science over there, you can use it in a very easy way and you can make it more interesting. So that can be done. Yes, multiple sound also we can add over there in that application. Yes. So the two tool I have discussed over here, one is Tinkercad and the second is Scratch. You can use both of them for learning purpose and both are open source. You can use it and you can use it for remote learning also. So whatever you are making it, you can share it with your students and you can export it and you can take a screenshot of this also and that can also be done. So that you can make it. Now I'm just talking about question answer. Before that, I'm just going to share with you my contact details. If any one want to know anything detail or want to plan any kind of further training program in detail in IoT, robotics and AI, so you can further contact me. So let me share with you my contact details. So you can feel free to contact me anytime if you face any difficulty while making any project or any kind of circuit over there or any kind of design over there in the Tinkercad and all that. So this one is my contact details. I think you are able to see it. Let me share it. Yes. So you can contact me anytime, whenever you face any difficulty while making it, or you can plan any training program for your student also, so that they can learn practically using these sensor and all that, and they can use 3D design also, and they can make circuit simulation also. So now if any participant having any kind of doubt, any kind of queries, they can type in the chat box or they can unmute their mic and they can ask their queries over there. So meanwhile, I will share with you a few more projects over here in the Tinkercad. So how you can make a piano, that I'm just going to discuss right now. So how you can make a piano, so let me go back to this and I'm going to talk about a piano making using this Tinkercad. So how you can make learning with a fun. So click over here in the circuit. These are projects. You can make some folder also for a project. So I just created a folder over here and I'm going to open and click. So this one I'm going to open and circuit over there we have to click it. Yes. So these are different circuits. So I'm going to open piano circuit. Think of this. So if you are not having any hardware and if you want to make some practical, want to do some practical, so that can be done using this Tinkercad tool. Like you want to perform some IoT practical or something like that, so that can be done. So this one is a piano, you can use it. And the, sometime if you are not in a technical background, like you are from applied science department, then also you can use these tools for teaching your kids also. So that is useful for everyone. So I'm just going to play that sargam tone over here. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa. So let's try to recognize it. If you recognize it, so you can type in the chat box. Yes, I'm going to play it. Sa. Are you able to recognize that Sargam, Saregama Badhanisa? If you recognize it, you can respond in the chat box. Yes. Yes. Yes, that is also good for school going student also. That's great. That's great. Yes, everyone is able to recognize it. That Sargam, Saregama Badhanisa. I mean, you can make learning with the fun. So that is very much important, because sometimes some student is having interest in music, but they don't want to learn about electronics and all that. But if they have to build something based on their music, on using that electronics and circuit, so they will able to enjoy it using these tools and without hardware. That's the beauty of this tool, so that you can use it. So I shared with you all the detail, and if you want to learn more about it, so I'm sharing with you my YouTube channel also. Over there you will find more detailed tutorial about this Tinkercad and few more about circuit and 3D design also. Innovate Skill e-learning, this one is Innovate Skill e-learning YouTube channel. So I'm just sharing over here that link. You can subscribe that YouTube channel also for getting latest update. So thank you so much. Now I'm just going to take your queries. If any participant having any kind of doubt, they can ask over here and feel free to ask. Yes, please.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, I'm Dheeraj Kapoor from Vash College Engineering, sir. Very good afternoon, sir.
Very good afternoon.
Sir, can we share that, we can say the project, like jo CAT hai, sir, humne banaya, wo kahin WhatsApp group or some other way, hum usko kahin share bhi kar sakte hai, sir, kahin?
वो आप डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं, लेकिन डायरेक्टली ऐसे शेयर नहीं कर सकते. आप उसे क्या कर सकते हैं, एनिमेशन बना लीजिए कि वो सिमुलेट हो रहा है आपका. तो okay. छोटी वीडियो रिकॉर्ड करके आप शेयर कर सकते हैं व्हाट्सएप पे ऐसे, बट ऐसे डायरेक्टली व्हाट्सएप पे शेयर नहीं कर पाएंगे आप.
और इन एनी अदर ग्रुप
अदर में जैसे कई ऑप्शन आपको वहां पे मिलेगा, जैसे कि साइन इन करके आपको कुछ लिंक मिल जाएगा इसका, वो आप शेयर कर सकते हैं.
लिंक शेयर कर दो.
यस,
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू.
नो जब हमें यूनो का प्रोग्राम हार्डवेयर पे अपलोड करना होगा, टिंकरकैड से डायरेक्टली अपलोड नहीं कर सकते. उसके लिए हमें आर्डिनो का आईडीई सॉफ्टवेयर है वो यूज करना होगा, कि वहां से हमें कोड कॉपी करके टिंकरकैड से और हार्डवेयर पे अपलोड करने के लिए आर्डिनो पे आपको अलग से आर्डिनो का सॉफ्टवेयर यूज करना होगा और वहां पे आपको पेस्ट करके कोड को अपलोड करना होगा. तो मैडम, इज देयर एनी डाउट? Any participant has any query, madam?
So, sir, I think Garima ma'am got disconnected. She's having some power issues. So, dear participants, if you do not have any further queries, then we'll end this session right now. So, I don't think, sir, there are any more queries.
Yeah.
So, I would like to thank you on behalf of Dhaliwal sir and Garima Saini ma'am. She personally called me to thank you on their behalf. She just got disconnected because of some power issue. So I wanted to thank you on behalf of the EC department also. So hope to get some other course also, sir.
Thank you.